What's going on, you guys? This is Aaron from Departures Capital, and welcome to the video. In this video, we're talking about an exciting new vegan stock called Plant & Co. Brands. Plant & Co. Brands, at the forefront of the plant-based revolution, Plant & Co. is focused on offering delicious and functional plant-based food to people in every facet of life. So this is going to be an introductory overview video. We're going to go over what the company's all about, how the stock's performed recently, and then, of course, I'd love to get your opinion. So drop some comments down below. Let me know what you think about the company, along with smashing that like button if you support the channel and all the videos, and kindly smashing the subscribe button along with the bell notifications on future videos. Also, for full disclosure details, this is a sponsored video. Check the description down below for full disclosure details, along with thoroughly reading our disclaimer and always remembering that these videos are not financial advice. Small cap stocks are highly volatile, which is why you should always do your own research and due diligence before investing. With that being said, guys, I hope you enjoyed this video. Let's get straight into it. So the first thing I want to talk about, and let's take a look here at the stock price. And to be honest, the charts are looking pretty good. You know, of course, not financial advice, but I am noticing a pattern here. We saw a nice little run up, pull back, and then a nice run up to all-time highs, and then a nice run up to 52-week highs with a pullback. Now, the stock has started to take off again, and by the looks of it, so far, it's made higher lows, which generally tend to be a good sign. Now, $22.16 million market cap in a 52-week range of 15 cents to $1.04. The stock currently trades for just 58 cents, so right in the middle of that 52-week range. So technically, the charts are looking pretty good. We'll see what happens over the next, you know, couple weeks. But I want to talk about some recent news for the company. So Plant & Co. to offer Yam Chops franchise opportunities across North America. So Plant & Co. Brands plans to aggressively expand its reach across North America by franchising the popular Yam Chops Grown Not Raised vegan butcher stores. Yam Chops is a wholly owned subsidiary of Plant & Co. specializes in the preparation, distribution, and retail sales of over 45 proprietary plant-based meats, chicken, pork, fish, and other delicious vegan food products. So a quick word from the company. Strongly believe a Yam Chops franchise system that is operated by an experienced entrepreneur or restaurant operator is poised for growth and market leadership due to our first mover advantage in the emerging plant-based protein and vegan butcher market, said Sean Moyes, Chief Executive Officer of Plant & Co. Brands. So with that being said, guys, let's dive into their website. So Plant & Co. Brands, as we can see right here, you can take a look at all the different products. What can you expect from Plant & Co.? As a growing 8% of the world population currently identify as vegan, vegetarian, or something in between, eating plant-based is not a fad diet. It is a lifestyle. Plant-based eating is the norm for the millennial generation, and they are influencing their parents and grandparents to eat the same. So there's some of their, this is their product portfolio. They've got Holy Crap, breakfast cereal, and more. They've got their Yam Chops. That's literally what we just talked about. First plant-based butcher shop in North America. And of course, shop online 24/7, now available Amazon and at their Holy Crap store. Shop in store. We can see where, you know, their products are offered. But we're going to dive into a very interesting article from microcapwatch.com. Holy crap, the new green wave is here and investors can't get enough of plant-based stocks. With its rapid-fire go-to-market strategy, Plant & Co. Brands is uniquely poised to blast into the lucrative U.S. market. So let's talk a little bit about the vegan market right now. So polls have found that 23% of Americans have already cut back on meat in 2019 and 47% more eating more plant-based foods during the current health crisis. A 2019 poll found that 41% of Americans, almost 135 million people, have tried plant-based meat before. Even better, 60% of those who had tried plant-based meats said they were either somewhat likely or very likely to continue eating them. Do the math, that's over 80 million Americans who have tried and liked plant-based meats. Which company has a competitive edge that will allow it to leap ahead of the pack? One company we believe deserves serious consideration is Plant & Co. Brands, a modern health and wellness food company focused on curating a top-notch portfolio of plant-based foods, immunity, and gut health products. It focuses on best-in-class brands that already have established products, proven sales, devoted customer brands, and valuable business-to-business and business-to-consumer distribution models. So let's talk about previous successes in the industry, or the plant-based, you know, other plant-based stocks. So if you went back in time and invested in its IPO, and we're talking about Beyond Meat here, and then sold it at its peak of $239 per share, you would have made over 800% return. So as we can see here, guys, there's multiple billion-dollar companies here. The Tattooed Chef, Beyond Meat, and then we have a couple others. Else Nutrition, $234 million. The Very Good Food Company, $499 million. And yeah, we know the value of Plant & Co. brands, just over $20 million. The market cap is tiny compared to some of its competitors. So let's talk about the top six reasons why Plant & Co. brands could be the next plant-based powerhouse. So rapid ability to capture market share by acquiring best-in-class brands that already have established products, proven sales, devoted customer brands, and valuable distribution models. Plant & Co. brands can quickly and efficiently acquire market share. Barriers to entry are effectively destroyed. Resilient and effective business model, targeting both business-to-business and business-to-consumer, makes the company more resilient but also more efficient, as wholesale distribution means it has less need for costly retail square footage. Number three, extensive and growing product portfolio. The company now offers over 30 proprietary plant-based meats, chicken, pork, fish, breakfast cereals, and various other vegan food products through both business-to-business and business-to-consumer distribution channels. Number four, undervalued compared to its peers, with a market cap of $22.8 million as of February 2, 2021. Plant & Co. Brands is trading at between 20 and 30 times sales, substantially lower compared to many large peers in the plant-based space. Number five, impending expansion into the giant U.S. market. The Canadian plant-based markets are a minnow. The U.S. is a whale. The market in Miami alone is 17 times that of Canada. Beginning in the second quarter of 2021, Plant & Co. Brands will aggressively enter the U.S. market using its proven business recipe from Canada. And finally, and we know how important management is, a superstar management team. The company's acquisition-focused model has also allowed it to acquire a management team that counts among its members, battle-tested brand-building experts, strategic marketing whizzes, and founders who have scaled businesses from seven figures to nine figures. Plant & Co. is assembling the best plant-based brands under one portfolio. So product development, the products have already been developed, like when the company acquired 100% of Holy Crap Foods in November 2020. Holy Crap Foods already had a line of successful plant-based breakfast cereals making $1 million a year and was also featured on Dragon's Den, the original Shark Tank. Since the takeover, Plant & Co. Brands has rebranded this product and expanded distribution with industry partners. It will also be rolling out new flavors of a small batch pre-order strategy, as well as increasing investment in influencer marketing. And I really think that influencer marketing is a thing of the future. It's an awesome way to leverage, and it's proven to work very well for certain, you know, aspects of certain businesses. So, but that was just the beginning. In January 2021, the company bought Yam Chops, Canada's first plant-based butcher shop. That single acquisition gave Plant & Co. Brands 48 product SKUs spanning 8 categories of plant-based alternative products. So let's talk a little bit more about their business. So Plant & Co. Brands stands ready to capitalize on this trend. Plant & Co. Brands doesn't just have Yam Chops 48 product SKUs in its portfolio. It also developed a new hemp-based meat alternative in partnership with the University of Manitoba's Agricultural and Food Department. Taking over 2 years of R&D and boasting natural flavors with enhanced textures. To top it off, the company is also opening Quebec's first vegan butcher shop in a matter of weeks. The trend data points to clear conclusion. Plant-based foods are not only here to stay, but are quickly shifting from niche to mainstream. Plant & Co. Brands, the next Johnson & Johnson of plant-based foods? That is the question. Plant & Co. Brands is just getting started, but as it continues to add more established brands to its belt, it could one day be the Johnson & Johnson of plant-based foods, with dozens of high-quality brands in its portfolio, each serving its own niche. This is not unlike how major F&B giants are structured. And it's true, as we can see here, guys, you know, Mondelez has all these different brands, Cadbury, and under Cadbury is multiple brands, and Kellogg's, multiple brands, General Mills, Nestle, Coca-Cola. So finally, guys, to wrap up this video, we're going to talk about the 8 key reasons, you know, you might want to take a look at Plant & Co. Brands. So number one, part of the fast-growing plant-based food market, which is expected to grow at 11.9% a year and hit almost $75 billion by 2027. Number two, business model of acquiring best-in-class brands that already have established products, sales, and distribution models effectively removes barriers to entry. Number three, business model also bypasses most of the challenges faced by food companies, product development, filling a gap in the market, and establishing a clear route to market. Number four, targeting both business to business and business to consumer customers makes the company more resilient as well as more efficient, less dependence on costly retail space. Number five, a rapidly expanding portfolio that already contains over 30 proprietary plant-based food products. Number six, market cap of only 22.8 million means that investors still have a chance to get in early. Number seven, company is expanding into the major league U.S. markets. In just a few short months, number eight, a rockstar management team with a proven track record of building brands and scaling the business. So guys, that's it for the introductory overview video. Take a look at plant and co-brands for yourself. Always remember to thoroughly do your own research and due diligence, and the fact that these videos are not financial advice, but they're simply just to introduce the company, maybe put it on your watch list so that, you know, you can, at the end of the day, make that decision for yourself if you like it or not. I appreciate you guys for watching. Drop those comments down below. Let me know what you think. For full disclosure details, always remember this is a sponsored video, so check the description down below for full disclosure details, along with thoroughly reading our disclaimer. And last but not least, always remember, guys, Departures Capital and Departures stocks are for information, education, and entertainment purposes only. Don't buy or sell a stock because you heard it on here. Buy or sell a stock because you've done your research, you've done your thorough due diligence, and you're making your own personal investment decisions for yourself. This video is not financial advice. We'll see you guys in our next video.